question one.
You can just answer one of them.
You just make this up as we go?
Yeah, you can make it up or you can read it from there, however.
Okay.
Ready?
Yeah.
I'm just thinking we
and just watch down. How you lean back, because I don't want you to get out of frame.
Am I pretty good?
You're great.
Okay.
Yeah, you got a little leeway, but just, you know, not too much back.
It just might just be distracted.
My name is Ben.
Question two. Tell me about positions you have held in the past. Also, tell me about your last job.
I worked for a company that went belly up here in 2000, and now I'm working for a programming company and another gaming company. And I'd really like to get back into more of the gaming, though, because that's probably the most exciting part about my job.
Question three. Why did you leave, or why do you want to leave your previous job?
Well, my current position is very demanding, and I spend a lot of my time fixing things that people screw up. You know, you got to put out the fires that people do, so I just got to get out there, and I want to be the one that's working on the programming.
Question four. Tell me a little bit about your past duties and achievements. Also, if you have any certification that might be relevant for future employment.
Well, let's see. I've worked with a lot of different programs, such as Perl, C, C++, and a lot of those programs. And having the C++ in my background really helps so I can understand any of the computer languages.
Question five. What type of position would be the ultimate position if offered to you?
I'd say the ultimate position would be the one where I get to work strictly with gaming that I've created, because it allows my creativity to flow, so that'd probably be the best.
Question six. Just so I can get to know the real you, tell me, apart from work, what do you enjoy doing? For example, hobbies or things you do in your spare time?
Well, let's see. Hobbies, I don't really have any. Basically, if it's not on a computer and to deal with programming and gaming, I'm not doing it. That's what I spend all my free time doing.
Question seven. What do you hate to do, specifically at work?
Hate to do. Probably accounting would be the number one thing. I can't stand working with the numbers and things all day. It's just not a fun process.
Question eight. What was your last salary and how much do you expect to get paid for your next position?
My last salary is about $125K per year, which I'm still making, but I'm willing to take a pay cut, you know, if it's something that I enjoy doing and it's not just accounting, you know. I'm willing to, but don't tell anyone that, you know. It's just, I want to do what I'm happy with.
Question nine. Tell me about your strengths and weaknesses.
My strengths would have to be definitely programming and working with the JavaScript, but my weakness, accounting, but I don't think that's a weakness, you know, I mean, it's just, I don't enjoy doing it.
Question 10. Do you have any questions for me, or if you would like to make additional comments, please use this time to do that.
Basically, I just want to say that I want to be able to just work with gaming all day, you know, that's probably my hobby, and but you know, what I like to do, so that's what I'm hoping to keep doing. Thank you.
Was that it?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, whenever you're ready.
Okay.
Question one. What is your name? Question one. What is your name?
My name is Ben.
Question two. Tell me about positions you have held in the past. Also, tell me about your last job.
Well, let's see. I worked for a company that went belly up in 2000. I've worked for EV Games, and I've done some programming, and right now I'm the head programmer at the company, and I think what I'd really like to do is get back into something more exciting. You know, gaming's probably the best thing.
Question three. Why did you leave, or why did you want to leave your previous job?
I think I want to leave because the position's very demanding. I mean, requires a lot of attention to detail and such, and I really am not enjoying that. I mean, I spend most of my time putting out fires, you know, fixing code that other people screw up. So what I'd like to do is basically focus on programming.
Question four. Tell me a little bit about your past duties and achievements. Also, if you have any certification that might be relevant for future employment.
I'd say knowing a lot of the computer languages such as Perl, Java, C, C, C++. They're really beneficial to knowing what you're doing. I think knowing the C++ language really helps you to get the programming done.
Question 5. What type of position would be the ultimate position if offered to you?
The ultimate position would be something that's revolved strictly around gaming, I think. It's just purely what I enjoy.
Question 6. Just so I can get to know the real you, tell me, apart from work, what do you enjoy doing? For example, hobbies or things you do in your spare time?
Well, there's not a lot of hobbies and basically any spare time that I'm not at work. I spend, working on doing programming and gaming. I mean, it's what I enjoy and it's what I use all my time for.
Question 7. What do you hate to do, specifically at work?
I have to say, the thing I hate the most, and I've thought about this a lot, is accounting. It's just not something I enjoy, the numbering. It's just a lot of...
Sorry, you can move that details. Back. The way it was. Yeah, sorry about that. Okay. You keep going.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's probably it. I mean, counting.
Question 8. What was your last salary and how much do you expect to get paid for your next position?
Last salary I made maybe $125,000 last year. I've been making it for a couple years, but... to be honest with you, I'm willing to take a pay cut if it's a position I really want. It's something I love to do.
Question 9. Tell me about your strengths and weaknesses.
Well, my strengths would definitely be, programming and the gaming. It's what I've always done. It's what I enjoy. And my weakness apparently would be accounting, because we talked about how I don't enjoy it. So I have to say that's my weakness. But I really don't consider it a weakness. It's probably just something we can pass off to somebody else to do.
Question 10. Do you have any questions for me, or if you would like to make additional comments, please use this time to do that.
The comment I have to say is that if you're looking for a guy, if you're looking to answer phones, to strictly deal with programming and accounting, then I'm probably not your guy. But if you're looking for a guy that is going to be the best of the best for gaming, then I'm your next employee.
Yeah, whenever you are.
Question 1. What is your name?
My name is Ben.
Question 2. Tell me about positions you have held in the past. Also, tell me about your last job.
Well, the positions I've held in the past, I've worked for a company that went belly up here in 2000. I worked for EB Game. I've worked for some programming companies, which I'm with right now. And that's about all the positions I've held.
Question 3. Why did you leave, or why do you want to leave your previous job?
I think the reason I want to leave my current job is it's very demanding, I don't enjoy doing the accounting, and it's a lot of numbers game here and there, so I probably have to get a reason.
Question 4. Tell me a little bit about your past duties and achievements. Also, if you have any certification that might be relevant for future employment.
I'd have to say the computer languages that I know really are beneficial to the programming of the computers, such as JavaScript, Perl, C, C++. They're just really good languages that help you to understand programs. Knowing C++ is probably the most beneficial language for the computer, because once you know that, you can kind of know every program.
Question 5. What type of position would be the ultimate position if offered to you?
The ultimate position offered would probably be something where I can work with the game, strictly with the game that I'm creating would be the best.
Question 6. Just so I can get to know the real you, tell me, apart from work, what do you enjoy doing? For example, hobbies or things you do in your spare time?
Real me, well, let's see, basically, I spend all my time, working on gaming and programming. If I'm not at work doing it, I'm at home doing it. It's kind of my life, I love it, so that's what I work on.
Question 7. What do you hate to do, specifically at work?
I hate to do it. It'd probably be accounting. It's the thing that I really don't enjoy. It's a lot of sitting and thinking and working with numbers, and you got to go through the contracts, and it's not something I enjoy. So that'd probably be the thing I hate the most.
Question 8. What was your last salary, and how much do you expect to get paid for your next position?
My last salary, I made about $125,000 per year, and
I mean, that's good, but I'm willing to take a pay cut. I mean, don't say anything, but, you know, if it's willing to let me do what I love to do, it's... I think that's what's about in the end, you know, working with what you love, and money should be secondary.
Question 9. Tell me about your strengths and weaknesses.
My strengths would obviously be the gaming and the programming. It's because it's what I enjoy, so I think you always work hard on what you enjoy. The weakness would be the accounting. However, I don't really consider it a weakness, you know. It's more of something that I don't enjoy, so, I mean, I can do it, but it's not a weakness.
Question 10. Do you have any questions for me? Or if you would like to make additional comments, please use this time to do that.
I'd have to say that if you're looking for a guy that's going to be just working on accounting, you know, answering the phone, secretarial work, you know, strictly programming or strictly gaming, I'm probably not your guy. But if you're looking for a guy to work on gaming and programming, then I'm probably your next employee. Thank you.
All right, whenever you're ready.
Okay. I'm going to start it, like, right now.
Okay.
Hello, my name is Jen. Well, I have worked for Floyd Design, Eaton Marketing and Research, and of course at Globelink, where I'm the current design guru in my position. Well, I'm actually still at Globelink, but I would like to expand my horizons a bit further. I want to work for a company that's going to expose me to, like, a lot of more projects. At Globelink, we're pretty much in information design work, and we're sort of stuck in maintenance mode.
Question 4. Tell me about your past duties and achievements. Also, do you have any certifications that might be relevant for future employment?
Okay. Well, first of all, I use a Mac. Mainly, but I'm also proficient in the PC or Windows environment. I'm an expert with the programs Photoshop, Quark Express, Adobe, Illustrator, Freehand, etc. I use all of these programs for my daily and graphic files.
Question 5. What type of position would be the ultimate position
offered to you? The ultimate position? Well, like I mentioned in question 3, I want to work in a design or marketing firm where I will be exposed to numerous and many design concepts and requirements from various companies and not just one. I don't really want to be working on maintenance either. Well, I really enjoy painting. I try to spend my free time doing oil painting landscapes. I think it really helps me kind of connect with nature, as well as kind of help me to learn about different colors, which is kind of interesting for my job.
Question 10.
What do I hate to do? I hate repetition in any of my projects. That's why I'm looking for a job that will help me not do repetitive things. I also don't really like learning new programs. It's one of, like, a pet peeve of mine, but it's important, so I'll probably be stuck learning some new things.
Question 8. What was your last salary, and how much do you expect to get paid for your next position?
Well, currently, I make around $70,000 a year. I'm looking to make around the same of that, as long as I work for a design or marketing company. My strengths are that I think I'm very talented. I'm really good at just coordinating colors for designs. I've also had over 10 years of experience with all the major Photoshop kind of design applications that are available right now. As far as weaknesses are concerned, I'm having a really difficult time getting motivated to learn Macromedia Flash, which is something really important, so I'll learn it soon, I promise. Okay, well, I actually do not have any questions for you, but I just want to say that I really look forward to discussing more of these options with you, and I think it will be a great opportunity to work with your company, so thank you.
Yeah. What is your name?
My name is Jen.
Quick question. Why did you or why do you want to leave your previous job?
Well, I'm actually still at Globelink, but I would like to expand my horizons a bit. I'm looking for a company that will help me be exposed to more projects. At Globelink, we're pretty much done with major design work, and our company is sort of stuck in maintenance mode.
Question 4. Tell me a little bit about your achievements. Any milestones or metrics that made you indispensable in your previous position?
Well, I was awarded the Designer of the Year award at my old company. I also did really well in design school, just kind of graduating at the top of my class. I've always been interested in design work, and I've traveled all over the world kind of studying architecture and different sorts of art forms just to kind of help me with this.
Question 5. What type of position would be the ultimate position offered to you?
The ultimate position, well, like I said in question 3, I really want to work in a design environment where I'm going to be kind of exposed to a lot of different design and marketing kind of techniques and design requirements versus just like one company's specific needs. Also, I'd rather not be working solely on just company maintenance.
Question 6. Just so I can get to know the
Let's see, this little spare time that I have, I really enjoy painting. I try to spend my weekends doing oil paintings of landscapes. I really love just being out in nature and kind of being in tune with the landscapes. Also, it's really great just to be able to make new colors, and I like to apply it to my job.
Okay, whenever you're ready.
Question 7.
Well, I hate repetition in any of my projects. That's why I'm looking for a job that will kind of let me do a lot of different things. Also, I really don't like learning new programs, which is probably not good, so I'm going to try to change that. Well, my current salary pays $70,000 a year. I'm actually looking for just something just around that number, as long as I'm looking for a designer marketing firm. Okay, well, first, my strengths is definitely just I love the use of color, and I think I'm pretty good at coordinating just color design in general. I've also had over 10 years of experience with all the major software applications regarding design. My main weakness is probably just my hesitance to learn Macromedia Flash, which I promise I will learn soon.
You're okay, I just want to let this question play out.
Well, I don't have any more questions, but I do want to say thank you for giving me the opportunity to interview with this your company. It's got a stellar reputation, and I can't wait to see what happens. Thank you.
Okay. So I see you've been narrowed down to 4 people, but I'm not going to waste any time. You, you, and you. You're out of here. You, you're hired. You're flying with me.
Bullshit.
You come with me. What are you supposed to say? You can't fire me, I quit.
Oh.
I don't think you should quit.
Well,
that
was the bad version of the impression.
We're still recording?
That's alright. It's just videotape.
Okay.
So go in the outtake room.
One more?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. We need more emotion out of the fireys.
Me or them?
I guess I don't know.
So I see. Okay. Cut, roll them, whatever.
Cut? Roll count.
So I see you've been narrowed down to 4 candidates. I don't want to waste any more time. You, you, and you. You're out of here. You come with me. Can't see you. Hi.
You got the job.
You got the job.
Take my job and shove it.
You can't fire me, I quit.
You've never been hired.
You don't want the job anymore.
Jen, take it easy there.
Yes.
So I see you've been narrowed down to four candidates, but I'm not going to waste any more time. You, you, and you. You're out of here. And you, you're hired.
Yes. Sorry.
You got the job.
Can't fire me, I quit.
I guess you want a fat guy.
Am I a fat guy?
Okay.
Thanks. Whenever you're ready, Stephanie.
Okay.
Question one. What is your name?
Hi, my name is Stephanie.
Question two. Tell me about positions you have held in the past. Also tell me about your last job.
I have held positions as a court clerk, a teacher's aide, and my last position was the assistant to the president of technologies company.
Question three. Why did you leave or why do you want to leave your previous job?
I want to work for a company that supports my educational objectives. That company did not.
Let me just stop you for a second. That's great. I just want to change angles before you move on. Get a little closer.
It's like, wait, it's not connected.
Alright, great. Okay, when you're ready.
Okay. Wait.
Question four. Tell me a little bit about your past achievements, maybe milestones or metrics that made you indispensable in your previous positions.
In my previous position, I prepared memos. I also made arranged meetings and travel arrangements for the president. I have a certificate of proficiency in Microsoft Office, and also I am working towards my PMP certificate to become a project manager.
Question five. What type of position would be the ultimate position if offered to you?
To me, the ultimate position would be to work for a Fortune 1000 company that provides benefits such as educational reimbursements and major medical, things along those lines. I really want to work for a company where I can set my roots down and stay for a very long time.
Question six. Just so I can get to know the real you, tell me, apart from work, what do you enjoy doing? For example, hobbies or things you do in your spare time?
I hang glide and I also enjoy martial arts. I also play the piano.
Question 7. What do you need to do, specifically at work?
I pretty much like to do anything related to my position. I don't like unnecessary busy work because I feel like it's an obstacle between me and my work goals. But other than that, I don't have too many demands, and I really like to put my full day's work in to help the company grow.
Question 8. What was your last salary, and how much do you expect to get paid for your next position?
In my previous position, I was paid $16.75 an hour. I would like to get at least $18 an hour, or even preferably $20.
Question 9. Tell me about your strengths and weaknesses.
I would consider the fact that I'm extremely organized a strength of mine. I feel like it helps me achieve my goals and my obligations fully. A weakness would be sometimes I am a little bit late to work because I'm an extremely careful driver, and that causes me to be late when the traffic is exceptionally bad. But on the upside, I've never been in an accident, and I'm a very, very safe driver.
Question 10. Do you have any questions for me? Or if you would like to make additional comments, please use this time to do that.
Actually, I do. I just wanted to ask if there were any unanswered questions that I could answer for you, because if there were, please let me know, and I would like to personally answer them. Also, I'm a very, very fast study, so I can adapt to any position that you see me fit for. So thank you very much for your time and for the opportunity. Have a great day.
Thank you.
you whenever you're ready.
Question one. What is your name?
Hi, my name is Stephanie.
Question two. Tell me about positions you have held in the past. Also, tell me about your last job.
I have held positions as a court clerk, a teacher's aide, and my last position was the assistant to the president of a technologies company.
Question three. Why did you leave, or why do you want to leave your previous job?
I left my previous position because I want to work for a company that supports my educational objectives. This company did not.
Question four. Tell me a little bit about your past achievements, maybe milestones or metrics that made you indispensable in your previous position.
In my previous position, I prepared memos. I also prepared arranged meetings and travel arrangements for the president. I also have a certificate of proficiency in Microsoft Office, and I'm working towards my PMP certificate to become a project manager.
Question five. What type of position would be the ultimate position if offered to you?
In my opinion, for me, the ultimate position would be to work for a Fortune 1000 company that provides major benefits such as educational reimbursements and major medical, things along those lines. I really want to work for a company where I can set my roots down and stay for a very, very long time.
Question six. Just so I can get to know the real you, tell me, apart from work, what do you enjoy doing? For example, hobbies or things you do in your spare time?
Well, I like to hang glide and I enjoy martial arts. I also play the piano.
Question seven. What do you hate to do, specifically at work?
There really isn't too much that I hate to do. I like to do anything that's related to my position. Perhaps the one thing I do dislike is unnecessary busy work, because I feel like it's an obstacle between my work goals, and so that I don't like to do. But other than that, I really don't have too many demands, and I really like to put in a full day's work to help the company grow.
Question eight. What was your last salary, and how much do you expect to get paid for your next position?
In my previous position, I received $16.75 an hour. I would like to get at least $18 or even preferably $20 per hour.
Question nine. Tell me about your strengths and weaknesses.
Well, I'm extremely organized, so I count that as one of my strengths. It helps me achieve my obligations and goals fully. As far as weaknesses, sometimes I am a little bit late to work, but that's because I'm a careful driver, and when traffic is exceptionally bad, it takes me a little bit longer to get to work. On the upside, I've never been in an accident, and I'm a very safe driver.
Question 10. Do you have any questions for me? Or if you would like to make additional comments, please use this time to do that.
Yes, actually I do. As soon as you can you please let me know if there are any unanswered questions? I would like to answer them for you personally. Also, I'm a very fast study, so I can adapt to any position that you see me fit for. So, thank you very much for the opportunity and your time. Have a great day.
Okay, whenever you're ready, sir.
A little bit more.
A little bit.
You can cut it off right there.
A little bit more towards the computer, you're saying?
Closer, actually. Yeah. Just a little more.
A little in more?
Yeah. That's it.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Ready? Okay.
Question one. What is your name?
Hi, my name is Stephanie.
Question two. Tell me about positions you have held in the past. Tell me about your last job.
I have held positions as a clerk.
Question one. What is your name?
Hi, my name is Stephanie.
Question two. Tell me about positions you have held in the past. Also, tell me about your last job.
I have held positions as a court clerk, a teacher's aide, and my previous position was the assistant to the president of a technologies company.
Question three. Why did you leave, or why do you want to leave your previous job?
I left my previous position because I wanted to work for a company that supported my educational objectives.
Question one.
Watch
Lena. What is your name?
Hi, my name is Stephanie.
Question two. Tell me about positions you have held in the past. Also, tell me
Stephanie,
about your last job.
Say it out loud, you know. Oh. Shoot, I made a mistake
and,
or something like that.
And if you could stay in a little bit closer. If you
right here?
Just don't move much back further than that.
Okay.
Thank you.
Gotcha. Let's do this again then.
Question one. What is your name?
Hi, my name is Stephanie.
Question two. Tell me about positions you have held in the past. Also, tell me about your last job.
I've held positions as a court clerk. I gotta do that over.
Question one. What is your name?
Hi, my name is Stephanie.
Question two. Tell me about positions you have held in the past. Also, tell me about your last job.
I've held positions as a court clerk, a teacher's aide, and my previous position was the assistant to the president of a technologies company.
Question three. Why did you leave, or why do you want to leave your previous job?
I want to work for a company that supports my educational objectives. This company did not.
Question four. Tell me a little bit about your past duties and achievements. Also, if you have any certification that might be relevant for future employment.
In my previous position, I prepared memos, arranged meetings, and travel arrangements for the president. Okay, let's try that again.
Question one. What is your name?
Hi, my name is Stephanie.
Question two. Tell me about positions you have held in the past.
Water. Okay, great.
Question one. What is your name?
Hi, my name is Stephanie.
Question two. Tell me about positions you have held in the past. Also, tell me about your last job.
I've held positions as a court clerk, a teacher's aide, and the assistant to the president of a technologies company.
Question three. Why did you leave, or why do you want to leave your previous job?
I left my previous position because I wanted to work for a company that that supported my educational... Okay, let me just start that over.
Question one. What is your name?
Hi, my name is Stephanie.
Question two. Tell me about positions you have held in the past. Also, tell me about your last job.
I've worked as a court clerk, a teacher's aide, and my previous position was the assistant to the president of a technologies company.
Question three. Why did you leave, or why do you want to leave your previous job?
I want to work for a company that supports my educational objectives. Shoot, I'm going to have to start that over.
Question one. What is your name?
Hi, my name is Stephanie.
Question two. Tell me about positions you have held in the past. Also, tell me about your last job.
I have held positions as a court clerk, a teacher's aide, and my previous position was the assistant to the president of a technologies company.
Question three. Why did you leave, or why do you want to leave your previous job?
I left my previous position because I wanted to work for a company that supported my educational objectives. This company did not.
Question four.
I'm going to stop right there for a second.
Tell me a little bit about your past duties and achievements. Also, if you have...
Was that last one okay?
That was perfect,
okay.
Yeah. So just, like, take your hand out. You can leave your hand in. We'll try it, like, two different ways.
Okay.
So leave your hand in there and then, you know, just click.
Okay. Now?
Mm-hmm.
Question five. What type of position would be the best position?
Now try it again and just, like, make it a little bit more, like, define that you're doing it, you know?
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
And whenever you're ready, I'm just going to keep rolling.
Okay.
Question six. Just so I can get to know the real you, tell me, apart from work, what do you enjoy doing?
Okay, and can you try it one more time and just take your hand completely out from the beginning and then put it in and hit it and then completely out at the end? Because I could still see it a little when it was next to there.
Okay.
Thanks.
I'll even move the mouse a little.
That's perfect,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Question seven. What do you hate to do, specifically at work?
So, let's see. Okay, so whenever you're ready, just move the cursor and click the next button or the start. do it once and click the next button, and then do it another time and hit the start over button.
Okay, excellent. Okay. Ready?
Yeah, whenever you are.
Question 8. What was your last salary, and how much do you expect to get paid for your next position?
Okay, yeah.
Question 1. What is your name?
Okay. Hi, my name is Stephanie.
I'm going to try and get that again because I want to try and see the question. I didn't see that. I was just on the buttons. I want to see the questions change as you hit them. Wait a second now. What's going on here? Okay, whenever you're ready.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Question 2. Tell me about positions you have held in the past. Also, tell me about your last job. Question 3. Why did you leave, or why do you want to leave your previous job?
Okay, I go to the start over.
Question 1. What is your name?
Okay, great.
My name is Naughty Bear right there.
Yeah, right in the interview. Do you drink on the job?
Whenever you're ready, man.
Alright. And action.
Question 1. What is your name?
My name is Jermaine.
Question 2. Tell me about positions you have held in the past. Also, tell me about your last job.
Well, I've worked as a cameraman, public advisor. I ran for president, but I lost to George Bush.
Question 3. Why did you leave, or why do you want to leave your previous job?
Well, I'm just exploring other opportunities to see if they can do me any better.
Question 4. Tell me a little bit about your past duties and achievements. Also, if you have any certification that might be relevant for future employment.
Well, I have an MBA from Harvard and have a project management certification from PMI.
Question 5. What type of position would be the ultimate position if offered to you?
The ultimate position would involve something in the entertainment industry, preferably working with someone like DreamWorks or Digital Graphics.
Question 6. Just so I can get to know the real you, tell me, apart from work, what do you enjoy doing? For example, hobbies or things you do in your spare time?
Well, I'm a collector. I collect antiques, 1960 cars, baseball memorabilia, and stamps. And I also attend several trade shows throughout the year.
Question 7. What do you hate to do, specifically at work?
Well, nothing comes to me off the top of my head at this moment, but probably cold calling and sales. I mean, if I had to, I would do it on the job, but I'd rather leave that to the experts.
All right, Jermaine.
Okay.
This is great. I just want to get another angle, or just get a little closer recovery for that stuff there.
Before you change, do you want to do the keyboard thing at all?
Yeah, yeah.
Before you change the angle?
Yeah. No, I just meant like, yeah.
Okay.
Change.
Let's go next, next, next.
Okay. Question 9. Tell me about your strengths and weaknesses.
One more.
Question 10.
Okay, stop.
Do you have any questions for
me, or if
you would like to
submit to this gracefully? Hopefully.
That other computer was a lot, looked a lot better on the screen. You see all that flickering that we're getting? Is there any way to change the refresh or... I'll give you a seizure if you look at it long enough.
I can hardly see it, it's pretty dim.
Okay. Got it. Sure. And let's select the programming. Okay, it's going to start now.
We are happy to see that you would like to record an interview. We have created this page to help you prepare and
just
have an
type your answer.
While you go through the interview, the answers you type here will appear on the screen during your interview. This will help you answer the questions asked by the interviewer.
Just a reload. I don't know why that happened.
We are happy to see that you would like to record an interview. We have created this page to help you prepare and have it in front of you while you go through the interview. The answers you type here will appear on the screen during your interview. This will help you answer the questions asked by the interviewer. Another benefit is that the text will be indexed, so when the employers are searching, they will find you better because there will be more keywords associated with your interview answers. So, start the text part of the interview, then click on the save button when you...
That's good. It's going to be a very short thing.
Right, yeah, I'll try and zoom out a little quicker. Okay. Okay, so I'm rolling, so just, you know, you're typing and thinking and answering.
Okay, that's good. Oh, I was in the light.
Oh. Try it one more time.
Rolling, right?
Rolling.
Testing 1, 2.
Question 1. What is
your... Okay. I should have, actually, I think I should go log out and log back into one of these other...
You think JS may have a problem with this, the fingers coming out?
With your, yeah.
No. Okay.
Good call.
Okay, want me to start again?
Should I get a tight shot of that little login username and password section?
No.
Just take the full screen there? Okay.
Hold on a second, I gotta think which one to use. Which one of these guys would look better? I mean, we're gonna see their video here.
Of the actual video?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I have a little bit of a variety of her stuff already, so, but I guess whoever had the most light on them, her or... Can you take a look at their videos to see?
Yeah.
Which one you would choose?
Question one.
I'm going to pause it now.
Excuse me, yeah, go ahead.
Okay.
Question one. What is your name?
Hi, I'm Jen.
Question two. Tell me about positions you have held in the past. Also tell me about your last job.
Well, I worked for Floyd Design as well as Eaton Marketing and Research, and now I'm currently working at GirlsLink, where I'm the design girl at Core Division.
Question 3. Why did you leave, or why do you want to leave your previous job?
Well, I'm actually still at GlobeLink, but I would like to expand my horizons a little bit and work for a company that...
Too much.
That was good. But let that question roll again, because there was nothing over that one. That would be good to use.
Which, this question?
Where she says she wants to expand her horizons or something.
That will expose me to more projects. At GlobeLink, we're pretty much done with all the major design work, and now we're sort of focused on maintenance mode.
Question 4. Tell me a little bit about the tools you use for designing. Specify for web, for traditional media, etc. Also, tell me about any certification.
I'm gonna pause a second.
This is a voiceover part where Mark will talk about the manual invitation or the link for the website.
Can we try this where I'm kind of zooming in on that little window there?
Yeah.
So I don't get your fingers and we can see what you're doing.
Okay.
This is invitation form?
Yeah.
Oh, whoa. Where, put it where you want it on the screen. Are you going to leave it there? I was just going to try and zoom in on it.
Why don't you start from here and then go down and stay there?
Far out do you want? All right, so like there and then there.
Go out a little bit more. That's it. So no, in a little bit.
From here. Okay, and then you're gonna type?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Question 1. What is your name?
My name is Ben.
Question 2. Tell me about positions you have held in the past.
We'll do that again without
also
the
volume. Also, tell me about your last
that.
Job.
Yeah. I'd like to also,
okay.
Alright, go ahead.
Question 1. What is your name?
My name is Ben.
Question 2. Tell me about positions you have held in the past.
Not
also,
long enough
tell
or
me about your last
yeah,
job.
That's good.
Yeah, I've worked for a startup company that...
Should I do it over again?
1 second. Try it. Do it one more time. Okay, now what do you click on?
Resume.
Okay.
And scroll down.
Okay, wait a second. Where do you click next?
4 stars.
Okay, 1 second.
5 stars.
All right, so click on one of them and then, okay.
Okay, now I can go and watch the video for Ben Demo, which is the second one.
Okay.
And programming.
1 second. Okay.
Question 1. What is your name?
My name is Ben.
Question 2. Tell me about positions you have held in the past. Also, tell me about your last job.
I'm going to see.
I've worked for a startup company that went belly up in 2000. Worked for EB Gaming as a Java programmer. And now I'm with a company called The Next Thing. I'm the head programmer of it. I'd like to get back to something more exciting, you know, such as gaming.
Question 3. Why did you leave or why do you want to leave your previous job?
Well, my current position is very nice.
Save button.
I'm the main programmer that everyone comes to. I spend most of my time putting out files.
Where's that?
Fixing
bottom right.
Other programs that people messed up. So, but I'd like to be...
No, you want to do it again because I was moving. I was trying to frame up.
Question 1. What is your name?
That's it, pretty much.
So just clear it completely, yeah. Alright, 1 second. 1 second. Okay.
Do you want to get it so it just comes up clean?
Yeah.
Computers, you know, they had problems and they say, I can't do that. I can't. Okay, I'll take a look at it. I go in there, I start typing in, and you see all sorts of.
You know what's embarrassing is that having to.
They get embarrassed.
My dad's computer.
And think right. That I'm on an Apple Macintosh.
Right. Okay, whenever you're ready.
Oh, should have cleared it. Oh, well. Let me see if I can clear it so it'll come up clean.
Or even maybe,
like live.
But when you start to type it, it'll.
Oh, you know what? Forget about the www. I just put nextemploy.com.
Oh, okay.
He might not have that much. That's okay. Okay?
Yeah, I just want to get that banner there. I guess that's good.